Transcendental knowledge, sloka number 10. So please chant after me. Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Sloka number 10. Vita
Vita
Raga
Bhaya
Krodhā
Vīta-rāga-bhaya-krodhā
Man-mayā upāśritāḥ
Bhagavo
jñāna-tapasā pūtā mad-bhāvam āgatāḥ vīta-rāga-bhaya-krodhā
man-mayā
upāśritāḥ bahavo jñāna-tapasā pūtā mad-bhāvam āgatāḥ vīta-rāga-bhaya-krodhā upāśritāḥ jñāna-tapasā pūtā mad-bhāvam āgatāḥ
vīta-rāga-bhaya-krodhā
man-mayā
upāśritāḥ
bahavo jñāna-tapasā
pūtā mad-bhāvam āgatāḥ
vīta-rāga-bhaya-krodhā
man-mayā upāśritāḥ
bahavo
jñāna-tapasā pūtā mad-bhāvam āgatāḥ
vīta-rāga-bhaya-krodhā
man-mayā upāśritāḥ
bahavo jñāna-tapasā Raga,
attachment.
Bhaya, fear. Krodhāḥ, and anger. Mat-mayāḥ, fully in me. Mam, in me. Upāśritāḥ,
being fully situated.
Bahavaḥ,
many.
Jñāna,
of knowledge.
Tapasā,
by the penance.
Pūtāḥ,
being purified.
Mad-bhāvam,
transcendental love
for me.
Āgatāḥ,
attained. Being freed from attachment, fear and anger, being fully observed in me and taking refuge in me, many persons in the past became purified by knowledge of me. And thus they all attained transcendental love for me. Purport. As described above, it is very difficult for a person who is too materially affected to understand the personal nature of the Supreme Absolute Truth. Generally, people who are attached to the bodily conception of life are so absorbed in materialism that it is almost impossible for them to understand how the Supreme can be a person. Such materialists cannot even imagine that there is a transcendental body which is imperishable, full of knowledge and eternally blissful. In the materialistic concept, the body is perishable, full of ignorance and completely miserable. Therefore, people in general keep the same bodily idea in mind when they are informed of the personal form of the Lord. For such materialistic men, the form of the gigantic material manifestation is supreme. Consequently, they consider the supreme to be impersonal. And because they are too materially observed, the conception of retaining the personality after liberation from matter frightens them. When they are informed that spiritual life is also individual and personal, they become afraid of becoming persons again, and they so naturally prefer a kind of merging into impersonal void. Generally, they compare the living entities to the bubbles of the ocean, which merge into the ocean. That is the highest perfection of spiritual existence, attainable without individual personality. This is a kind of fearful stage of life, devoid of perfect knowledge of spiritual existence. Furthermore, there are many persons who cannot understand spiritual existence at all. Being embraced by so many theories and by contradictions of various types of philosophical speculation, they become disgusted or angry and foolishly conclude that there is no supreme cause and that everything is ultimately void. Such people are in a diseased condition of life. Some people are too materially attached and therefore do not give attention to spiritual life. Some of them want to merge into the supreme spiritual cause and some of them disbelieve in everything. Being angry at all sorts of spiritual speculation out of hopelessness. This last class of men take to the shelter of some kind of intoxication and their affective hallucinations are sometimes accepted as spiritual vision. One has to get rid of all three stages of attachment to the material world. Negligence of spiritual life, fear of spiritual personal identity and the conception of void that arises from frustration in life. To get free from these three stages of the material concept of life, one has to take complete shelter of the Lord, guided by the bona fide spiritual master and follow the disciplines and regulative principles of devotional life. The last stage of devotional life is called bhava or transcendental love of Godhead. According to Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu 1.4.15-16, the science of devotional service adham shraddha tatah sadhu sango atah bhajana kriya tato anartha nivruti hisya tato nishta ruchit tatah atah shaktis tato bhavas tatas prema yudhanchati sadhakanam ayam premnah pradurbhavi bhavit kramah. In the beginning, one must have a preliminary desire for self-realization. This will bring one to the stage of trying to associate with persons who are spiritually elevated. In the next stage, one becomes initiated by an elevated spiritual master and under his instruction, the neophyte devotee begins the process of devotional service. By execution of devotional service under the guidance of the spiritual master, one becomes free from all material attachment, attains steadiness in self-realization and acquires a taste for hearing about the absolute personality of Godhead Sri Krishna. This taste leads one further forward to attachment for Krishna consciousness, which is matured in bhava or the preliminary stage of transcendental love of God. Real love for God is called prema, the highest perfectional stage of life. In the prema stage, there is a constant engagement in the transcendental loving service of the Lord. So, by the slow process of devotional service, under the guidance of the bona fide spiritual master, one can attain the highest stage, being freed from all material attachment, from the fearfulness of one's individual spiritual personality, and from the frustrations that result in void philosophy. Then one can ultimately attain to the abode of Supreme Lord. Please repeat the translation.
Being freed
from attachment,
fear and anger,
being fully
absorbed in me,
and taking refuge in me,
many persons
in the past
became purified
by knowledge of me,
and thus
they all attained
transcendental love for me.
Namo Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prashnaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swamini Tinamine Namaste Saraswate Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pashati Deshatarine Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Vashadi Gaura Bhakta Vranda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna. Today's sloka, in one way, it is like an essence of bhakti. So, there are four parts in this sloka. First, what Krishna says, vīta-rāga-bhaya-krodhā, being freed from attachment, fear, anger. This attachment, fear, anger, it is a material attachment, fear and anger. Because in spirituality also attachment, anger, fear is required. So what Krishna says is material fear and anger. Then second point, Krishna says many persons in the past, they got liberated by taking knowledge of me. After taking knowledge, they fully absorbed in me. For this, they took complete refuge in me. Complete shelter in me. So one is getting freed from material qualities. Second is accepting the knowledge of Krishna. Third is completely absorbed in Krishna. Fourth is taking refuge. So if you follow this, what will happen? We will get transcendental love to Krishna. So why transcendental love? Because that is the love or that taste what the soul is expecting from many number of birth. So this is the process. First, complete, come out of the impurities, then follow the process of devotional service and get the pure love towards Krishna. So what is this attachment? When the attachment will come? So here knowledge is there, right? So now, if you have knowledge, positive knowledge about a subject matter, then obviously I will get attraction towards that subject matter, right? So when I have attraction, what will happen? I will try to engage myself or associate myself with that subject matter. So then attachment arises. So when there is a strong attachment, what will happen? I will observe myself in any activity related to that subject matter. See, suppose a girl, when
Hare Krishna.
Suppose a girl is pregnant, okay? She will start to develop a desire to see the child soon, right? Now, once the child comes, obviously the mother will get attached to the child. Now, once the attachment arises, what will happen? The mother herself observes herself in protecting the child, in taking care of the child, okay? So what is the absorption? A-B-S-O-R-P is also there. A-B-S-O-R-P is also there. Absorption. Absorption. What is meant by absorption? Suppose if I take a cotton and if I dip in the water, what it will do? observe the water, right? So similarly, when a jivatma and another jivatma unites in relations, okay, the jivatma will try to observe the love from opposite. That is what called observe. So now what Krishna says here, after getting knowledge of me, the soul has to, like many sages, being fully observed in me. So here absorption refers to devotional service. So by performing devotional service, constantly the soul, the sages, they were transmitting the love between themselves and the Supreme Lord. Okay. See, now in this material world, absorption, for the soul, absorption, it is not a choice. It is not an alternate choice. The soul has to be always absorbed in any one of the subject matters. If I am not interested in Krishna consciousness, then obviously I have to get absorbed myself in any one of the subject matters, material subject matters. Okay. So for example, for an IT people, what is the absorption? I have attraction towards money, that's why I am working in IT industry. And what is my absorption? I don't have time to embrace my son or daughter or my wife. Okay. All day I will work with my laptop and mobile. So laptop is my first wife, mobile is my second wife. And this headphone what I am carrying, that is like my son or daughter. And whole day I will keep working, doing programming, doing coding, designing, talking to the clients, and at night I will just close the laptop and I will sleep. And once I get up, again open the laptop, before even brushing my teeth or taking bath, I have to see who has sent email, whether any update from client, whether the client has agreed the proposal or not. If suppose, if there is even a single missing task, then I will get fear. Right? Suppose some of my team members, they failed to complete the task on the time. If they failed to meet the deadline, then I will get anger. So in material activities, every material activity, attachment, anger, fear is constant. We cannot avoid that. For a hotel owner, what is the absorption here? He is also attached to money. At the end of the day, he has to protect his idli or dosa or dough, batter in the fridge. So that same thing he can supply tomorrow. Suppose his fear is it should not get spoiled. Suppose if it gets spoiled, he will show anger towards his labors. So like that, absorption, attachment, fear and anger, in every material activity it is there. The soul cannot avoid that. Like that, various people will have different kinds of attachment, fear and anger because of the absorption in their corresponding activities. Narasimha Purana gives one story of a businessman. There was one businessman. That businessman, he was always absorbed in making money, engaged in only doing business. So his son got worried. He was a cloth merchant. So his son got worried, and his son, what he did, he called a sadhu. He said, my father, although he has become very old, the problem is he is not able to give up the business. So I require your help to help him to bring him out of the business. Because it is the old age, above 60. So he has to engage himself in spiritual activities. Now what happened? The sadhu agreed. The sadhu took his father, that cloth merchant, to many dhams, many spiritual places. So the sadhu was thinking, okay, very soon this cloth merchant will become a wonderful devotee. At the last, what happened? The sadhu took the cloth merchant to Kasi. In Kasi, we have various ghats, right? Ghat sections we have, and they will burn the dead body. So the sadhu said, my dear cloth merchant, you look at these dead bodies. That they are burning, right? And the body is getting burnt away, and you see, nothing. After they burn the body, it's just one cup of powder, that's it. Nothing else. Okay? And this is what you desire. Whole life you were doing cloth business, right? You have wasted time. So that cloth merchant started crying. After seeing the dead bodies, like they were keeping the dead bodies. On the top of the dead bodies, they were keeping lot of wood. And this cloth merchant, after seeing that, he started crying. Yes, I wasted my life. Continuously tears were coming on his cheeks and he was weeping and crying. So the sadhu felt, okay, finally my mission has been accomplished. And the sadhu asked, okay, now what is your realization? Tell me. Whatever you have told is correct. I have wasted my life. Whole life I was doing only cloth business. I didn't know that there is a heavy demand for this wood in Kasi. If I would have known that there is a heavy demand for this wood in Kasi, I would have started the wood business long back. And by this time I would have doubled and tripled my money. Whole life I wasted. Now I am more than 60, I cannot do anything else. I don't have energy also in my body. So what happens, if somebody, whatever value I will give more importance in my life, that becomes the object of my goal in my whole life. Same thing happened some 10 years before, 15 years before. Similar incident happened. There is a Gaudiya Mutt in Chennai. So one sannyasi, he takes care of the Gaudiya Mutt. And one day, one of the life member visited Gaudiya Mutt. And he requested the sannyasi, Maharaj, Maharaj, my father is in coma. He is admitted in hospital, he is in ICU. And he is in coma. And we require your help. So you please come and chant the holy names of Krishna. I don't know whether he will get recovered, but at least sadhus like you, if you come and bless him, there is a chance that at least in the next birth he will get an opportunity to perform devotional service. So Maharaj agreed. Maharaj said, okay, because it is not that you are life member, I will come. It is my duty that I should help other souls. So that sannyasi agreed. It happened in Gaudiya Mutt. The sannyasi agreed. And the sannyasi went to the hospital, ICU. 2 or 3 days, the Maharaj was chanting holy names of Krishna. He was reading Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam. So after a couple of days, that person got recovered from coma. So Maharaj was there, his son was there, and that person opened his eyes. So the nurses and doctors, they were expecting what would be his realization. So as soon as he opened his eyes, his son was expecting, okay, the father will share some realization, variable realization. So very eagerly he was waiting. And Maharaj was not at all bothered. Because looks like Maharaj knew what he is going to say. So Maharaj was just simply chanting, glaring at his face. And the old person, father, he got up and he asked, what is the current rate of the tire today? And Maharaj, no. So Maharaj didn't say anything. And Maharaj asked, what business you are doing? So the son said, we have our own tire shop. 2-wheeler and 4-wheeler tire shop. And my father, last 40 to 50 years, he was doing this tire business. And Maharaj said, see, this is the problem. Because of not having sufficient spiritual knowledge, the soul gets attracted towards this material world, and he sets himself some material goal, and towards that material goal he gets attraction and attachment, and he keeps himself absorbed in fulfilling that material goal. And what will happen at the end of the life? Whatever I have been absorbed for so many years in my life, only that will come. Right? Because 40 to 50 years I have been absorbed in certain activity. So this attachment, fear, anger, it is available both in spiritual life as well as material life, but one cannot avoid that. Now, Krishna says, first you get come out of this attachment, fear and anger, okay. Second, Krishna says, get the knowledge of me, okay. That Krishna says, fully absorbed in me. And fourth, what the Lord says, take refuge in me, okay. So in that way, one will get the transcendental love for Krishna. Okay, now, being freed from attachment, fear and anger, what is the solution for this? But how it will come? Okay, by chanting. Shravanam Kirtanam. Okay. All answers are correct. Now, one common sloka, one famous sloka is available in Srimad Bhagavatam. Attachment, fear and anger. Exactly for this, one famous sloka is available in Bhagavatam. Huh? No, I am asking sloka. Surrounding, you mean association again. Krishna is the center, okay, but again to come to that stage that keeping Krishna in the center, that will take some time. But how to go to that stage? Satsang. No, initiated devotees should know that sloka. It is there in Bhagavatam. Even one who chants one round, two round, they should also know that sloka. No, it is a famous sloka in Bhagavatam. See, in Bhagavatam, know the answer? That we already read in this purport. See, we all know Kali Yuga is so fallen and it is a ocean of mistakes. It's very difficult to find even one good quality in Kali Yuga. So, Mandaha, Sumandha, Madhya, everybody is misguided in all aspects. It is not only spirituality, even in material life also, we are completely misguided. Okay. Now, most of the souls in Kali Yuga, they don't want to hear anything about spirituality. Either they don't have taste also about Krishna. Okay, first thing to know about God itself very difficult. And after attempting to know about God, to come to the conclusion that Krishna is the Supreme Lord, that is still more difficult. Okay, even after knowing that Krishna is the Supreme Lord, to practice with consistency, that is still more difficult. Now, like most of us still, we feel chanting is a painful work, right? Because we are doing chanting as a burden only. It is not that out of love we are doing. Okay. It is like 24 hours I have to chant. For example, if I am working under a politician, okay, let's say 10 hours I have to keep chant Rahul Gandhi, Rahul Gandhi, Rahul Gandhi. And at the end of the day, I won't get any salary. So that is how we are doing chanting now. We are chanting Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. But at the end of the day, neither we want to engage ourselves in service. Even if somebody wants to give some service, we want to avoid that. Okay. So in Bhagavatam, first canto, 7th chapter, 7th sloka, it says, Yashyam vai sruyamanayam Krishna parama puruṣe bhaktir utpatyade soka moha bhayapaha bhaktir utpatyade pumsaha soka moha bhayapaha. Simply by the oral reception of this Vedic literature, one's loving devotional service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is Krishna, immediately will arise in the heart of the devotee and it will extinguish the soka moha bhayapaha. It will extinguish the fire of fear, anger and lamentation. So when I have an attachment towards some subject matter, the moment I lose, I will lament. Okay, so that is the result of attachment. And fear, I have to come out of that fear. So it has to be a fearlessness. I am fearful, I have to come out of fearlessness. Then bhayapaha. So this sloka says, just simply by the oral reception of Srimad Bhagavatam, immediately one's loving devotional service to the lotus feet of Krishna will arise. Now why it is loving devotional service? In that same chapter, same sloka, Srila Prabhupada writes in the Purport, in this material world, this terminology love is very often used to define the relationship between man and woman. Right? Whenever a young boy glares at a young girl, friends will ask, right, what happened? I am falling in love with her. In love also, in material world, love means falling in love, not getting up. So fall in love, okay. But Prabhupada says, in that same purport, this word love, it can be properly used only to define the relationship between Krishna and the living entities. Because this word love, either Krishna has to show to the living entity or the living entity has to show that bhava, okay, that mood to Krishna, only that is called love. In a false conception, in material illusion, if a jivatma selects another jivatma and try to transmit that mood, that is not love, it is completely lust. So that's why in third chapter, before the end of the third chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says the lust is the first enemy for the soul, which will always keep the soul in this material world. So out of lust, attachment grows, then fear, anger, it keeps growing. Okay. So what happened? Because we have a false conception, false illusion that we are this body and we are product of this material world, we always try to keep ourselves with material goals. We don't have spiritual goals. Okay. See, suppose in my family, to my relatives, if I tell, I am very busy in my company, morning 8 o'clock I will go to my company and night 9:30 I will come out of my company. Whole day I am always engaged, completely occupied with so many work. Okay. If you tell this way, people will appreciate. Yes, he is in such a high position, see, he is completely engaged. Suppose to my friends or relatives, if I tell I have only 4 hours job, morning 6 to 10. That is very easy to accomplish. But from 10 to till night, I have too much task in my spiritual life. I have to complete 40 rounds. Then 2 hours I have to read Bhagavatam. Then minimum 2 hours I have to read Bhagavad Gita or Bhagavatam. Then I have to go to temple and I have to do various service. If I tell something like this, anybody will appreciate? No, right? Because what happens? Because of that illusory nature, okay, it is very difficult to set the spiritual goal. And even if we set the spiritual goal, if we share about that spiritual goal with others, it is very difficult to get appreciation. There is one story Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur used to tell, Mr. Fool story. There was a king, okay, he was very pious king. He had a very big, gorgeous big kingdom. So one day a saintly person visited that kingdom. That saintly person was very merciful toward that king. The saint understood that he is very pious, but it is my duty to save him. Because he, in illusion, he thinks that he has to always protect his prajas, kingdom, people, and so that they can always remain happy. But that is a false conception. Because in this material world, good or bad, both are bad only. If I do good, what it is meant by, I am assisting others in their sense gratification. So the more one engages in sense gratification, the attachment towards this material world will increase. Okay, what is bad? I am disturbing others' personal life. That is bad. So in that way, in this material world, good or bad, both are bad only. Pious or sin, both are bad only. So this sadhu, he said, this king said, I have to do one service for you. So you tell me what, how I can serve you. So the sadhu said, okay, you no need to do service. As a saint, I have to help to you. Okay, I have this danda stick, right? I am giving to you. The king took that danda. The king saw. The king asked, what I should do with this danda? The sadhu said, you try to find a fool number one in your entire kingdom and give this danda to him. He thought, how I will find the fool number one? No, you will find out. So the king agreed. So the king took the danda from the saint. So the king was keeping, daily he was searching, who is the fool number one in my kingdom. So finally they found out one fool. And the king called, the king said, okay, it is my duty to give this danda to you. Okay, you should always keep this danda. The fool agreed, okay. Per annum I am getting this salary just to keep the danda. Why I should lose that? So the fool agreed. So the fool was keeping danda all the day along with the king. And the fool was always with the king, keeping that danda. So one day, what happened? Not one day. This old age came. Obviously in old age nobody can be happy. The old age came. So the king became very sick. So the king understood that I am not going to remain in this body for long time. So very soon I am going to leave this body. So before that, let me call all my sons. Let me give this kingdom to them. And my ministers who served me for so long time, let me give some shares to them so that they can remain happy. Before ending my life, I don't want to put them into anxiety. So the king called everyone. The king gave all their shares to everyone. He installed his son as another king, next king. So everything done. Now the fool was standing with the danda. And the king thought, because for many years, this fool, he was carrying the danda because of my instruction and he was always with me. What I can give it to him? So the king called the fool. He said, your job is going to get over soon. Okay, what you can do? I will give you some money for your maintenance. Now you go. You can go. The fool said, then what I should do with danda? I got my share, I got my retirement profits, benefits. But this danda is with me, right? What I should do then? The king said, you try to fool, find a fool number one and you hand over this stick to him. Then the fool said, okay, I will do that. Now the fool asked, now you are asking me to go away, where you are going? He said, no, I am going to a place where I cannot come back. Okay, I will do one thing, I will keep all your clothes ready. You will travel 1 month, 2 months, I will keep that much of clothes. The king said, no, I cannot even carry my clothes there. Okay, at least I will arrange all the soldiers who can come with you. No, they also cannot accompany you. Okay, at least I will pack this much number of grains for you, so that on the way at least you can cook and you can eat. No, I cannot even carry the food. Then at least I will ask accountant to arrange for a little amount. On the way, on the journey, you need some amount, right, while traveling. The king said, no, I cannot even carry. Then what else you can carry? The fool got angry. The fool asked, what else you can carry? The king said, even I cannot carry even my own body also. Then the fool thought, okay. The fool took the stick and he gave it to the king. And the king asked, what are you doing? Why are you handing over the stick to me? The fool replied, I thought I was the fool number one in this entire kingdom, but today I understood you are the fool number one in this entire kingdom. You know that one day you are going to leave this body, and Shankaracharya says, even the cowpin cannot accompany the soul. The cowpin in the body, to protect our body we are wearing, to cover our body we are wearing, even that also will not accompany. You know the truth that one day you are going to leave this body, but still whole 70 to 80 years you are struggling to maintain this kingdom, and you are yourself absorbed completely in protecting the citizens and protecting the kingdom, thinking that you are the real protector. Who else can be the fool than you? So I am giving this danda to you. And he left. So this is the story, one of the Gaudiya Vaishnava story told by Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. So like that, what happens? Because we don't have sufficient spiritual knowledge, okay, we are struggling. Now, honestly tell me, how many of you are reading Bhagavad Gita or Bhagavatam daily? Okay, only one hand. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. No, you can rise at one shot, right? After telling 5, 6th person is rising. After telling 6, 7th person is rising. So why the knowledge of Krishna is so important? So now we discussed about attachment, fear and anger. Okay. Now Krishna says, having knowledge of me, then you can observe yourself in me. Why knowledge of Krishna is so important? So many times we discussed. A specialty about the center is, speaker himself has to ask question and the speaker himself has to tell the answer. See, you all know, right, there is one famous sloka in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Krishna is compared to light and Maya is compared to darkness. And when there is the presence of light, there is no possibility of darkness. Right, you all know, you have seen this verse anywhere? Where it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita? Actually, it is from Chaitanya Charitamrita. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, in Madhya Leela, 23rd chapter name is Process of Devotional Service. Process of Devotional Service.
So there it is, this sloka is given.
Krishna Surya Samamaya Haya Andhakara Yaha Krishna Tahamaya Nahi Adhikara.
Like wherever Krishna is there, there is no possibility of having Maya there. Now how to know about Krishna? When Krishna is there is no presence of Maya. See, it is compared to like, suppose there is a dark cave. For thousands of years, it remained as dark only. All of a sudden, a good soul lit the ghee lamp and he put the lamp inside the cave. Now, the darkness which surrounded that cave for many thousands of years, will the darkness can demand many thousands of years I was staying here, all of a sudden you came. So let me stay for another 10 years, then let me leave. The darkness cannot demand. The moment the light is there, the darkness has to be removed. Okay. Similarly, the moment Krishna is there, Maya has to be removed. Okay. So now, knowing Krishna means, what is the first step? In knowing Krishna, Krishna says, right? Unless I know Krishna, I cannot come out of Maya. Okay. In knowing Krishna, what is the first step? Before that, how you know that you have to accept the scriptural master? Chanting.
Listening
about Krishna will give what? So knowing, to know Krishna, first I have to get the knowledge about Krishna. Right? So getting knowledge about Krishna is the first step. Okay, but how it will happen?
By reading
Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam. But how you will know that you have to read Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam? So association of devotees. So only in association of devotees you will come to know that you have to read Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam to know Krishna. So once you start to get knowledge of Krishna, okay, what will happen? In the same sloka just now we discussed. Once I have knowledge, what will happen? Attraction. After attraction? Now I have knowledge of Krishna, right? But I am not taking any shelter. Still I am working in Infosys. So after knowledge of Krishna, attraction will develop. So when I have attraction, obviously I will try to serve with some attachment. So when I have attachment, I try to myself observe in performing devotional service to Krishna. Right? So now, knowledge, attraction, attachment, observe, then refuge. Okay? In Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam, 4th canto. Srimad Bhagavatam, 4th canto, 8th, 9th, 10th chapter explains the pastimes of Dhruva Maharaj. Dhruva Maharaj. This sloka, it is a suitable example for explaining Dhruva Maharaj pastimes. You all know, right, Dhruva Maharaj. Usually kids, they will read Dhruva Maharaj pastimes in moral books. Okay, but in Bhagavatam, 4th canto, 8, 9, 10, it describes the Dhruva Maharaj pastimes. Dhruva Maharaj, he is the son of Uttanapada. In Bhagavatam it is explained, Swayambhu Mano, who is the first Mano in this Brahma's day. In Brahma's day, 14 Manas will come. Swayambhu Mano, Swarojisa Mano, Uttama Mano, Tamasa Mano, Raitika Mano, Shakshusha Mano, Vaivasvata Mano, Dakshina Mano, like that Deva Mano, Savarni Mano, like that it will keep going. So in that first Mano is Swayambhu Mano. And Swayambhu Mano's son is Uttanapada. The Uttanapada has had two wives. So first wife's son is Dhruva. Dhruva, he had strong attachment towards his father. We all know he will try to go to his father, he will try to sit on his lap of the father. Now, his stepmother, she did it alone. She said, you cannot sit on the lap of your father because you have not taken birth in my womb. So, go down. Go away. So, after what happened, we all know, Dhruva Maharaj, he got extreme anger. He was just crushing his teeth and he walked towards his palace. So, before that, the news already passed to his own mother. Suniti. Suniti and Suruchi, two mothers were there. So his own mother, she got the news and both started crying. And his mother told, whatever your stepmother told is correct. You are really unfortunate because you have not got any opportunity to sit on your father's lap. So yes, better you go to the forest and worship Lord Vishnu. Okay, only he can satisfy your desire. So he agreed. Now he has attachment, he has anger. Fear is absence because he is a Kshatriya. Now Dhruva Maharaj got an idea. Immediately he left his home and he went to the forest. So in that meantime, Narada Muni got the news. Because they are from not a normal family background. They are just descendants of Brahma directly. Swayambhu Manu, right? So Narada Muni appeared in the scene. And Narada Muni first tried to pacify Dhruva Maharaj. Narada Muni said, you are a Kshatriya, I can understand. Kshatriyas cannot tolerate the humiliation. Okay, it is fine, but still you are 5 years old boy. Better you go away. Go to the your palace, better remain there. There is nothing wrong. So Dhruva Maharaj didn't agree to go back. So Dhruva Maharaj said, whatever you are giving advice, my dear spiritual master, yes, it is correct, but I am not in a situation to accept and follow that. I have to see Vishnu. Okay, if you can help me to accomplish that task, please help me. Otherwise, please give me away. So Narada Muni understood this boy has been completely determined to see Vishnu. Then let me help him. So Narada Muni agreed. And Narada Muni, what he did? Anybody has read Dhruva Maharaj pastime in his Bhagavatam? So what he did? Narada Muni, what he did?
He taught the sloka.
Okay. Which sloka? Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Okay. That is to chant and call the Lord. But before that, what he did? Narada Muni. No? Okay, fine. So what happened? Narada Muni understood the determination of Dhruva Maharaj. First, what Narada Muni did? Dhruva Maharaj understood Vishnu is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So, first level siksha, second level siksha, till fourth level siksha, no need to waste time. Now, Narada Muni's job is to describe the futures of Lord Vishnu. Because, see, we have photos available, we can just keep seeing Krishna's photo and we try to remember. And when we close, only cinema, movies and songs will be running. But in those days, no photos. So unless they hear, they cannot imagine a form of the Lord. Okay, and that futures, whatever Narada Muni has to explain, it should be exactly as Lord Vishnu's form. So first Narada Muni, in 5 slokas, Narada Muni gave the knowledge about Lord Vishnu. 5 slokas. 5 slokas, Narada Muni explained the bodily form of Lord Vishnu. Just by getting that knowledge, Dhruva Maharaj got attracted to that form. Still he has not seen the form. We have to remember, still he has not seen the form. Just by hearing from Narada Muni, in 5 slokas, Dhruva Maharaj got very much attraction. That eagerness increased. And then Dhruva Maharaj completely absorbed himself in meditating on Lord Vishnu. Now I will try to read that slokas and translation. The reason for reading is, we are always attracted to opposite gender. That is one. Either opposite gender or various material subject matters. Either TV, washing machine. If I am more, attached to car, then I will keep searching better cars. If I am more attached to laptop or mobile, I will keep searching the newer versions of mobiles. Right? So we are always attached to some form. Okay. Due to that, we always observe ourselves to achieve that. Now, Narada Muni describes the futures of Lord Vishnu, bodily futures of Lord Vishnu. Just by hearing that, Dhruva Maharaj got attraction. Similarly, we also daily read these slokas. What will happen? Very soon, in our heart also, we will get the desire to remember Lord exactly. Right? Remember the Lord exactly. Now I will read 45th sloka. So here it starts.
ప్రసాదాభిముఖం సస్పద్ ప్రసన్న వదనే క్షణం సుణసాం శుభ్రువం చారు కపోలం సురసుందరం.
ఫస్ట్ నారద ముని ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్స్ అబౌట్ ది లార్డ్ ఫేస్, లార్డ్ విష్ణుస్ ఫేస్. ది లార్డ్స్ ఫేస్ ఈస్ పెర్ఫెక్చువలీ వెరీ బ్యూటిఫుల్ అండ్ ప్లీజింగ్ ఇన్ యాటిట్యూడ్ టు ది డివోటీస్ హూ సీ హిమ్. He appears never to be displeased. He is always prepared to award benedictions to him. His eyes, decorated eyebrows, his raised nose and his broad forehead are all very beautiful. He is more beautiful than all the demigods. So first Narada Muni explains about eyes, eyebrows, nose, how it is situated. And what it is mentioned here, the Lord is always in pleasing attitude. So the Lord is always in a smiling form. In movies we might have watched, right? Heroine will just smile once at the hero and the hero will dance. She smiled at me, my love is success. But the Lord is always in smiling form. We never tell that the Lord is smiling at me, my birth is success. So then 46th sloka, it says
Tarunam ramaniyangam arunoshte chanadharam ప్రణతాశ్రయణం నిర్ణం శరణ్యం కరుణార్ణవం.
నారద ముని కంటిన్యూడ్, ది లార్డ్స్ ఫార్మ్ ఇస్ ఆల్వేస్ యూత్ఫుల్. ఎవ్రీ లింబ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ హిస్ బాడీ ఇస్ ప్రాపర్లీ ఫార్మ్డ్ ఫ్రీ ఫ్రమ్ డిఫెక్ట్. హిస్ ఐస్ లిప్స్ ఆర్ పింకిష్ లైక్ ది రైసింగ్ సన్. హీఈస్ ఆల్వేస్ ప్రిపేర్డ్ టు గివ్ షెల్టర్ టు ది సరెండర్డ్ సోల్ అండ్ ఎనీ వన్ సో ఫార్చునేట్ యాజ్ టు లుక్ అపాన్ హిమ్ ఫీల్స్ ఆల్ సాటిస్ఫాక్షన్. The Lord is always worthy to be the master of the surrendered soul, for He is the ocean of mercy. So in this, Narada Muni says, every limb and every part of His body is properly formed. So in material world, not in material world, there are two terminologies. Saundarya, Lavanya. Saundarya means, overall, if someone looks more beautiful, it is called Saundarya. And if I, like in material world, some person may look, appearance wise they may look very beautiful, but nose will be very long, eyes will be very short, so at least one limb will be defective part. But suppose even that person whose appearance overall looks beautiful, as well as each and every part also, if he separately look, it should look beautiful. That is called Lavanya. Even Shankaracharya, he written Saundarya Lahari, he didn't written Lavanya Lahari, because this terminology Lavanya, it applies only to Krishna. It cannot be applied to even any demigod who is more beautiful. So Narada Muni says, each and every limb of the Lord is so beautiful and it is perfect. It is completely out of defect. And third sloka, he says, now he explained about the face and overall body. Now Narada Muni explains about the other ornaments what the Lord is wearing.
శ్రీవత్సాంకం ఘనశ్యామం పురుషం బలమాలినం శంఖ చక్ర గదా పద్మైర్ అభివ్యక్త చతుర్భుజం.
శ్రీవత్సాంకం, ది లార్డ్, హీ ఆల్వేస్ హ్యాస్ ది శ్రీవత్స మార్క్. ది లార్డ్ ఈస్ ఫర్దర్ డిస్క్రైబ్డ్ అస్ హ్యావింగ్ ది మార్క్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీవత్స ఆర్ ది సిట్టింగ్ ప్లేస్ ఆఫ్ ది గాడెస్ ఆఫ్ ఫార్చూన్. అండ్ హిస్ బాడీలీ హ్యూ ఇస్ డీప్ బ్లూయిష్. ది లార్డ్ ఈస్ ఎ పర్సన్, హీ వేర్స్ ఎ గార్లాండ్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్లవర్స్. హీఈస్ ఎటర్నలీ మేనిఫెస్ట్ విత్ ఫోర్ హ్యాండ్స్ which hold a conchal, wheel, club and lotus. So Narada Muni further explains what the Lord is carrying. Shankha, Chakra, Gada, Padma. The Lord is carrying and he has Srivatsa mark, as well as he always wears a garland. And how is body color? Ghana Shyamam, deeply bluish. And fourth sloka.
Kiritinam kundalinam keyura vanayanvitam కౌస్తుభాభరణ గ్రీవం పీత కౌశేయ వాససం.
ది ఎంటైర్ బాడీ ఆఫ్ ది సుప్రీం పర్సనాలిటీ ఆఫ్ గాడ్ హెడ్ వాసుదేవ ఇస్ డెకరేటెడ్. హీ వేర్స్ ఎ వేరియబుల్ జ్వెల్డ్ హెల్మెట్, నెక్లెసెస్ అండ్ బ్రేస్లెట్స్. హిస్ నెక్ ఇస్ అడోన్డ్ విత్ కౌస్తుభ జ్వెల్. హీఈస్ డ్రెస్డ్ ఇన్ ఎల్లో సిల్క్ గార్మెంట్స్. అండ్ దిస్ ఇస్ ది లాస్ట్ శ్లోక.
కాంచీ కళాప పర్యస్తం లసత్ కాంచన నూపురం దర్శనీయతమం శాంతం మనోనయన వర్ధనం.
ది లార్డ్ ఈస్ డెకరేటెడ్ విత్ స్మాల్ గోల్డెన్ బెల్స్ అరౌండ్ హిస్ వేస్ట్ అండ్ హిస్ లోటస్ ఫీట్ ఆర్ డెకరేటెడ్ విత్ గోల్డెన్ యాంకిల్ బెల్స్. ఆల్ హిస్ బాడీలీ ఫ్యూచర్స్ ఆర్ వెరీ అట్రాక్టివ్ అండ్ ప్లీజింగ్ టు ది ఐస్. హీఈస్ ఆల్వేస్ పీస్ఫుల్, కామ్, క్వయట్ అండ్ వెరీ ప్లీజింగ్ టు ది ఐస్ అండ్ మైండ్. So after describing about the Lord's beauty, futures, bodily attractions, Narada Muni finally said,
evam bhagavato rupam subhadram dhyayato manah nirvritya parayaturnam sampannam na nivartate.
One who meditates on this way, concentrating his mind upon the all auspicious form of the Lord, is very soon freed from all material contamination, and he does not come down from meditation upon the Lord. So now this is what we are struggling in our chanting, right? We will start with the mala, we will chant one or two mantras, then mind will fly over, and when we about to complete the rounds, again mind will come and we will feel more happy. Not that we have meditated on the Lord, because we are about to complete our rounds. Okay, but Narada Muni says, so these five slokas Narada Muni explains about the bodily futures of the Lord, just by keep, and after that Narada Muni gave this mantra,
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
So Narada Muni said, Thruva, chant this mantra through your mouth, but whatever bodily futures, symptoms I told, right, just concentrate on that form of the Lord, and you keep doing, you will be able to see the Lord. So Narada Muni left, and what Dhruva Maharaj did, now he has got knowledge. By getting the knowledge about Lord Krishna, now he has got attraction by hearing the futures of the Lord. Now this attachment started increasing towards the process. Remember, still Dhruva Maharaj has desire for the kingdom, and he wants to sit on the lap of his father. He is not completely purified. Okay, now third thing, what he has to do? Observe, son. Okay, now Dhruva Maharaj, what he did? He knows this sloka. So Dhruva Maharaj, first month, what he was eating? Okay, how many months or how many years it took for Dhruva Maharaj to see the face, to see the darshan of Lord?
6 months.
Correct? 6 months. Okay, first month, what he was doing? I am wondering, because Dhruva Maharaj pastimes, it is present in so many moral books, and as part of our kids class we keep teaching, right? Okay, a routine of our class, speaker himself has to tell the answer. So okay, so Dhruva Maharaj, actually first 1 month, every 3 days, like once in 3 days, he was eating one time fruits, and he was keep chanting Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. He was chanting Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, but trying to concentrate on the form of the Lord which Narada Muni has given, explained. And second month, once in six days, he was eating only dry grass and leaves. Imagine, it's very difficult to eat leaves, right? Kari patar itself, you won't feel to eat. Whenever in prasadam comes, you will just take and keep aside. But once in 6 days, he was eating that. And third month, once in nine days. Which means, like, per month, I have 30 days. We have 30 days. So, 3 days only. That too, 9 days gap. Dhruva Maharaj drank only water. And fourth month? Air.
He was not eating anything.
Once in 12 days, he was breathing. So 30 days, okay, 12 plus 12, 24, which means only 2 times he took a long breath. And 5th month, so 1st month, once in 3 days, which is 10 days, 10, 3 we have. 2nd month, once in 6 days, so 4, 6 days I have. And 3rd month, once in 9 days. 4th month, once in 12 days, he took only one breath. And 5th month, even he didn't breathe also. He just controlled the breath. And 5th month, what happened? Completely observed in remembering the form of Lord Vishnu as described by Narada Muni. So exactly, he was able to focus on the Lord. Shankar, Chakra, Gada, Padma. eyes, nose, eyes and lips completely pinkish color, nose, raised nose, and wearing a golden helmet, and his dhoti was as brilliant as gold, and he was wearing anklets and small bells around his waist, and he was just smiling. And Dhruva Maharaja was just able to concentrate on the smiling face of the Lord. Now, like in our material world, a lover will say, yes, that girl smiled at me, I am very much happy. Like the Dhruva Maharaj felt happy, yes, I am able to concentrate on the smiling face. Now what happened, see, in this material body, I am the main soul of this body, but inside my body many germs and worms are there, right? Worms are there, they are also souls. But the main soul of this body is me. Similarly, in this material world, many planetary systems, many souls are there, but still the main soul of the universe is Lord Vishnu. Now what happened? Dhruva Maharaj, he was able to capture that form of Lord Vishnu, who is the soul of entire universe, and he controlled his breath. Others were not able to breathe. So demigods, they were struggling to breathe. They were not getting any oxygen. So immediately they rushed to Chirodakashaya Vishnu and they were praying, my Lord, we are not able to breathe, what is happening? And Indra was very much concerning about his position. My Lord, is there any problem with my position? So, no, that is the material nature. So if anything happens, like first self, we will try to give importance to ourself, then I will try to worry about others. So then Lord Vishnu said, my dear Indra, whenever anything happens, it is only for your position, don't worry, it is due to my devotee Dhruva. Even if you go and offer your designation, he won't agree. Unless I go, he won't open his eyes. So then Lord Vishnu, he went to Dhruva Maharaj. Actually Dhruva Maharaj went to where? I forgot to ask this question. Where Dhruva Maharaj did tapasya? Madhuvan, where it is? Near Vrindavan. So Dhruva Maharaj actually went to Madhuvan near Vrindavan and he took bath in Yamuna river, then he started this tapasya. And when Lord Vishnu appeared, he didn't even open his eyes. He constantly meditating on that form of the Lord, and Lord decided he won't open his eyes. Okay, I have to disappear from his heart, then only he can open. So all of a sudden, the Lord disappeared from Dhruva Maharaj's heart, whatever form Dhruva Maharaj was remembering, and Dhruva Maharaj got more disturbed. And Dhruva Maharaj, when he opened his eyes, whatever the form he was just meditating, exactly Lord Vishnu was standing there. And after that, what Dhruva Maharaj prayed? My Lord, give me one mobile cover. I have to complete my loan. I have to complete a 2 BHK loan. I am struggling in this life. Is this even Dhruva Maharaj's prayer? Daily I am fighting with my wife. Come and pacify. No, Dhruva Maharaj didn't pray this one. So what Dhruva Maharaj prayed? Dhruva Maharaj first cried. My Lord, I am so foolish that I did this tapasya for this material designation and positions, which is like a sprinkle of water in the hot desert. Because in the desert region, the more we walk, our body needs lot of water consumption. And in that region, if I throw just 2 drops of water, it will not be sufficient for the soul. So like that, in this material world, I was hankering for just designation and position. What I was hankering? Like my father, I wanted to have more big kingdom. And now I am feeling I have done bigger foolishness. After seeing you, what else I need? So after getting the knowledge of Krishna, Dhruva Maharaj got attraction and attachment. Because of that, he was able to observe himself in remembering Lord Vishnu, and he was able to chant the holy names of Krishna. And after that, what happened? He completely purified, finally taking refuge in me. He surrendered to Lord Vishnu. He said, I don't want anything. Just I saw your form, right? That itself enough. It completed. It gave me a complete satisfaction and full satisfaction. My Lord, this is enough. I don't want any more. But still Lord Vishnu said, don't worry. You are going to get liberation after this birth. And I am going to create a Dhruva Loka, pole star. And I am going to install you as the king of that Dhruva Loka. So you can enjoy for so many years. and then you can come back to me. So this is why we are discussing all this pastime. To know the importance of gaining knowledge, and if we gain knowledge, what will happen, we should know. And see, in this material world, everybody needs some role model. Right? Everybody needs some role model. Some, like, we want to be a follower of at least one person. Suppose if we get problem in our life, okay, if we don't know how to resolve that, then two things we will do. Either we will consult with an experienced person, or we will try to see if anybody has faced the same problem, how they overcome that. Right? How they overcame that problem. So we need one role model. We want to be the follower of at least one person. That we cannot avoid. Now, because we don't have spiritual knowledge, now we are taking role model of whom? Shah Rukh Khan, Salman Khan, Rajini Gandh. Like that, actors and actresses, we are taking them as a role model. Right? But when we come to the spiritual path, after getting the spiritual knowledge, we should just turn the pages of Srimad Bhagavatam. Whatever situations, calamities, problems, what we are going through, already many persons, more than as they have gone through. And if we refer their life history, right, we will get enough sufficient solutions to handle our problems. So that is the reason we have to go through the pages of Srimad Bhagavatam. Right? Like that, we have to get the knowledge of Vishnu. Similarly, we are worshipping Radha Madhav, right? Where it is mentioned, Krishna is wearing peacock feather, two hand Krishna holding fruit. Where it is mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam? 10th chapter. Tenth canto. Where it is mentioned? See, without reference, we will not be worshipping, right? Now, Narada Muni gave the sufficient knowledge to Dhruva Maharaj. Dhruva Maharaj was able to install that form in his mind. Similarly, we are worshipping Krishna holding flute. Where it is mentioned? Why we are worshipping this form?
Prabhupada told.
That is correct. Yes, that is correct. Prabhupada only gave. But how? From where? Acharyas.
Acharyas would have seen.
Acharyas where? Took this form and installed.
It is in Venugit.
Huh? Venugit.
Brahma Samhita.
Brahma Samhita. No, I am asking in Srimad Bhagavatam. In 10th canto. In 10th canto, there is a chapter, separation of the gopis is there, right? Their gopis are glorifying Krishna. How Krishna was dancing. So, I am sure nobody knows this sloka, it is fine. So, it is said that, Barha peetam natavaravapuhu karnayo karnikaram bibhratvasah kanaka kapisam vaijayantim chamalam randhran velor adarasutaya purayan gopavrindhair vrindharanyam swapadaramanam pravisad gita kirtihi. Barha peetam means the Lord was wearing peacock feather. Natavaravapuhu karnayo karnikaram. Karnikaram means it is a special type of forest flowers which is have very nice, pleasant smell. The Lord took that. He decorated his head and ears. Natavara Vapuhu. When a dancer is about to perform dance in the stage, the dancer has to decorate themselves very nicely. How the Lord decorated himself? The Lord decorated himself as the best of the dancers in the entire creation. Barha peetam natavara Vapuhu karnayo karnikaram bibhradvasah kanaka kapisam vaijayantim chamalam. So he was wearing this Vaijayanti mala. When the Lord was just walking, the Vaijayanti mala was also hanging, swinging. Okay. Randhan venor adhara sudayo purayan gopa vrindhai. All the gopas surrounded the Lord, and the Lord was joyfully was playing the flute. And what is the last line? Vrindharanyam swapadaramanam pravisat gita kirtihi. Vrindharanyam. In the entire land of Vrindavana, Lord Krishna, he was printing his footsteps, and he was purifying the entire land, and the gopas, Gita Kirtihi, they didn't have even a single envy towards Lord Krishna, and they were glorifying continuously Lord Krishna. Similarly, there is another sloka where in Srimad Bhagavatam 10th canto, it is explained about Lord Krishna's future.
శ్యామం హిరణ్య పరిధిం వనమాళి పర్హా ధాతు ప్రవాళ నట వేషం అనవృతాంశే. శ్యామం, ది లార్డ్ హూ ఇస్ వేరింగ్ పీకాక్ ఫెదర్, హీ వాస్ కంప్లీట్లీ బ్లూయిష్. హిరణ్య పరిధిం, హీ వాస్ వేరింగ్ ఎ ఎల్లో గార్లాండ్, సారీ ఎల్లో గార్మెంట్ విచ్ వాస్ యాజ్ బ్రిలియంట్ యాజ్ గోల్డ్ అండ్ హీ వాస్ డ్రెస్డ్ లైక్ ఎ డాన్సర్. విన్యస్త హస్తం ఇతరేన ధునానాం అబ్జం. He just took his hand, he was standing, he rested his one arm on the shoulder of one gopa and with other hand he was just carrying lotus flower and his forehead was very broad and he looked very beautiful. Like the three slokas are there in Srimad Bhagavatam, exactly describes about the future of Lord Krishna. So the conclusion here is, to come out of attachment, fear and anger, we have to first get the knowledge of Krishna. If we have to, once we get the knowledge of Krishna, our attraction and attachment towards Krishna will increase. Then we can observe ourselves in performing devotional service to Lord Krishna. Now, in order to continuously meditate on the Supreme Lord, there are various slokas in Srimad Bhagavatam available. Now, our only issue is procrastinating. Tomorrow I will read, day after tomorrow I will read. Someday, I will retire from my life, I will take a small house somewhere outskirts in the city and I will sit whole day, I will keep reading Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita and I will relish the Bhagavatam, I will relish each sloka. That gold ending is never going to come in Kali Yuga. Because clearly Shukamuni, Shukarishi says in Bhagavatam 9th canto, Kalau Janishya Mananam Dukkha Soka Tamodudam. This sloka also many times we have already discussed. Whoever appears in Kali Yuga, they are always filled with Dukkha Soka Tamodudam. Always having material anxiety, some kind of like not able to explain what is the worry going in my mind, but still always it will be going. So, and to that conditioned souls, Krishna appeared. Kalau Janishya Mananam Dukkha Soka Tamonudam Anugrahaya Bhattanam Supunyam Vatanot Vasaha. To that soul, Krishna appeared so that they can keep, discuss Bhagavatam, remember the Lord form, and observe themselves in constant, consistent remembrance of the Lord. Right? Now, in this material world, another problem is this Maya. Maya Devi is so strong, it is keep pushing the soul to sleep on her lap. Dhruva Maharaja was hankering for his father's lap. Finally, he got Vishnu's lap. Now, we are sleeping on the lap of Maya, but we have to transcendent this level and we have to try to get the lotus feet of Krishna. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, same Madhya Lila 22nd or 23rd chapter, 31st sloka, it says, even once if a soul goes in front of this form of Krishna and if the soul says, my Lord, so many birth, I know I have fallen down into this material world and I have been separated from you, I have already passed many birth. But now I have come to you, my Lord. Now I am a sincere and serious servant of you. I want to serve you. I want to take shelter at your lotus feet. My Lord, please save me. Even once, if a soul jokingly tells, immediately Maya flies away. Krishna will definitely protect that soul. It is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya Lila, there is a chapter called Principles of Process of Devotional Service. Process of Devotional Service. So it is mentioned, I exactly don't remember this sloka, but it says, Maya Bandha Haite Krishna Ekabar. Sorry, I don't remember exactly this sloka, but it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita. So, and in the same chapter, it is also written, by regulated reading and discussing philosophy about Krishna, intelligence and mind will get strength. And very soon, the soul will come out of the illusion. So today class, I know it is a very hardcore philosophy. It is little boring subject matter for a conditioned soul. But still, we have to take the pain to read Srila Prabhupada's books. Then only we can ourselves observe in remembrance of Krishna, in serving. So it is example is given. Suppose a person's lungs is filled with enough mucus and there is absence of oxygen, the person cannot breathe properly. In that situation, if the person has to climb the hill, it is impossible for the person to climb.
because normal breathing itself doubtful, how the person will climb, right? Similarly, when our mind is completely filled with impurities, magnet attracts magnet. Impurities will attract impurities. That is the reason we are not able to hold the form of Krishna. So if we have to clear the mind, we have to clear all the impurities in our mind, then without any alternate option, we have to follow, we have to accept the devotional service. That is the only option where the contaminations of mind will go. Those who are regularly chanting and reading of Srimad Bhagavatam, they might have already this realization. So I will stop the lecture here, it's already 6:22. So the conclusion is, we have to read daily Srila Prabhupada books, then only consistently we can chant the holy names. Otherwise, very soon we will stop the chanting also. There is no any other surprise. So Hare Krishna, I will stop here. Any questions, doubts you can ask. No, you can ask Mataji, I can hear.
Hare Krishna.
ओके
हम हिंदी में हम ये जानना चाहती हूँ अचानक एक दिन रात को 11 o'clock से मतलब टेम्पल के अंदर जाते हैं और उन्होंने वापस नहीं आई तो इसका क्या रीजन है क्या कारण उनको क्या हुआ था वो मंदिर को अंदर गया है फिर रिटर्न नहीं आया हम बहुत पूछने का बहुत लोगों को सवाल किया है पर कोई कोई बोला आप श्री चैतन्य चरण चरण जो बुक्स आते हैं वो पढ़ तो अभी तक हमारे को मौका नहीं मिला इसलिए हम जानना
ठीक है यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इंग्लिश लिटिल बिट
थोड़ा
थोड़ा हमको भी हिंदी थोड़ा थोड़ा मालूम है इट्स ओके इट्स ओके सो आई विल ट्राई टू टेल द आंसर इन my Hindi, because I am from Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu Hindi is little strange. Okay, so Mataji's question is, what happened, how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu disappeared? Oh, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ka mrityu kaise hua? Wo bhi aap puch rahe hain. Mrityu nahi?
Hame bhi maloom nahi.
Wo ant kal mein kya hua? Wo Jagannath Mandir ke andar gaya, phir kya hua? Ye bhi aapka prashna hai. Mera Hindi acha hai. Okay, so Mataji's question is, we all know Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared. See, in case of Krishna, we have evidence. Krishna, he retired to Prabhāśa-cetra and a hunter came and Krishna gave the darshan to that hunter and Krishna left this material world. So before going to Goloka Vrindavan, Krishna paid a small visit to Brahmaloka. Then he proceeded. Similarly, in the past times of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, what happened? Okay, so the evidence is there, Mataji. The evidence is, actually, one version it says, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went inside Jagannath Mandir. He entered Jagannath, body of Jagannath. He disappeared. So Jagannath, Bhagavan Jagannath ka wo deity hai na, vigraha hai na. Unka andar gaya, wo Goloka Vrindavan chala gaya. वो थोड़ा साधु लोग क्या बोलता है तोटा गोपीनाथ है ना आपका मालूम है तोटा गोपीनाथ सो चैतन्य महाप्रभु वेंट इन फ्रंट ऑफ तोटा गोपीनाथ ही मर्ज्ड हिमसेल्फ थ्रू द थाइस ऑफ द गोपीनाथ सो राधानाथ स्वामी महाराज इन इस्कॉन ही सेड एक्चुअली चैतन्य महाप्रभु मर्ज्ड विद तोटा गोपीनाथ दैट्स इट ही डिसअपीयर्ड और तोटा गोपीनाथ विग्रह है वो उनका अंदर चैतन्य महाप्रभु गया वो गोलोक वृंदावन गया नहीं माता जी चैतन्य चरितामृत और चैतन्य भागवत में ऐसे कोई नहीं लिखा है मुझको भी पता है मैं भी सीनियर डिवोटीज के साथ पूछूंगा हाँ वो क्या है दो पॉइंट बोल रहे हैं कुछ लोग बोल रहे हैं वो जगन्नाथ के अंदर जाकर डिसअपियर हो गया और कुछ लोग बोल रहे हैं तोटा गोपीनाथ के सामने महाप्रभु गया और महाप्रभु क्या हुआ उस समय राधा रानी का भाव में था उनका नाम है पराके रस बहुत टॉप मोस्ट रस ठीक है उनका भाव में चैतन्य महाप्रभु था वो क्या हो गोपीनाथ का शरीर के अंदर गया वो डिसअपियर हो गया. आपको आंसर मिल गया. ठीक है, हम भी हिंदी सीख गए. ओके ओके सुना था बाबू जी बोल रहे हैं वो टोटा गोपीनाथ इधर है ना. घुटना सी गांधी नाले चल रही थी घुटना के अंदर गया. ओके Prabhu's question is, Dhruva Maharaj pastime happened in various different yugas, like Satya Yuga. And those yugas, the spiritual practice, those yugas were really suitable for performing spiritual practices. Now we are in Kali Yuga. Now how to get taste in the chanting? Okay, because for Dhruva Maharaj, process was little faster. He was in different yuga. But for us, we are in Kali Yuga. First, we have to get the taste in chanting. Then how